Hello, UTAB Nation people. It is Tom, and today we're going to take a little bit of a different direction. I like to do showcase videos from time to time, just because, hey, we do lots of AHK here. There's so much other great things out there that can help you speed up your day. You know, that's what we talk about with AHK, with automation, but there are other tools out there. So here's a new one for PDFs, Adobe Acrobat. A lot of people have it, but a lot of the features can cost money. So, I believe at the time of filming this video, you know, back in the day, you used to be able to buy a program, just one price, you had it for life. You know, Photoshop was like that, a lot of programs out there were like that, but now everything's going subscription-based, which annoys the crap out of me. What about you? Do you like the subscription-based thing better or worse? My vote is for worse, because in the long run, you're paying more money. If you only need something for a month or two, sure, you might have saved with the subscription. So I'm kind of curious to see, you know, your guys' opinion. So definitely let me know in the comments below. But we're going to be looking at PDF 24 Toolbox. So there is a website. So yeah, here we go. $19. That's going to add up very quickly, even in just a year, like now. So, we got this website right here, pdf24tools.org, or, actually, I was wrong on that one, but anyway, that will be in the description below. So, here's what it looks like. Now, right off the bat, you see I am in dark theme. There's a little thing right here, and you can just toggle. It got, you know, the normal, and then it got, like, this orange thing, where it just, I think the only change is that it puts orange around the boxes, and dark mode. I like dark mode. We're going to go with dark mode. So yeah, this basically has, as far as I can tell, almost every feature that Adobe has with PDFs. I mean, you got some pretty cool stuff here, PDF OCR, like the title says, it's all completely free. So this is the website app. I mean, they got so many options here. So these are kind of the most common used ones, I guess, that people are using. You know, there's some really cool ones in here, like create a PDF with a camera. I've done this on my phone before with, like, scanner apps. We kind of take a picture. It kind of helps get rid of the wrinkles. It crops it, and basically puts it into a perfect square like you had done it on an actual, like, printer-scanner combo kind of thing. So with this, you could hold it up, like, with my camera right now, like this. Take a picture. It'll crop it, all that. Now you can scroll down. Big old orange button here, press that, and there's going to be more. So, top still looks the same, but now you have this more section. So, you got some stuff here, you got conversions. So, someone sends you an Excel file, but you want it to be a PDF, you know, Word to PDF, etc. Lots of formats here. Half of these formats I haven't even, like, heard of. Like, I have no idea what an ODG file is, or an ODT. I don't think I've ever heard of those, and if I have, I just completely forgot because I've never used them before. And on the opposite side of stuff, you can do PDF back to something. So PDF to Excel, PDF to Word, you know, lots of options here also. And up here, you got a desktop version. So you can click that. It's going to be a normal, like, zip file and zip it with whatever you're using. You know, install it where you want. Normal stuff. So here is the actual desktop application. So here, it's basically looks about the same, has all the same stuff, but it's a desktop version. So you got all that here, you got a bunch of stuff here, and then you also have your favorites section. So favorites is easy, you're just doing the little star down here. So let's say I'm using split PDF, I can add that. So under favorites, you know, there's all that if you just want to see only your favorites. Last used, I haven't obviously used anything yet on the desktop version, but that's where these would be and all. Now, I did check this. It's not showing up. I think you just got to go here and push reload. Yeah, so you just got to reload it manually. This also has toggle themes. Doesn't have that orange one. It just has only light and dark, which is fine. I don't really get the orange one. So yeah, and then you can also search, you know, if I want to search for, let's see, OCR. So I can type in OCR, and, So I spelled that wrong. OCR. And I really like this user interface because, as you see, it's still everything's still there, but it's highlighting just that. And I really like that. I mean, I just think that's a really cool user interface. I know some people would like it to sort everything, so it's just showing like maybe your three results here. But I don't know. I like this. I think it's a really cool experience. But I could see people liking it the other way also. But yeah, as far as right now, they don't have that kind of functionality. There's no release settings in this. But yeah. So, like I said, this is completely free. I stumbled across this randomly somewhere. I forget. I think it was someone mentioned it in a comment having to do with AHK or something. So shout out to whoever that person was. I found this like weeks ago and completely forgot. So shout out to the unknown person who led me to this. It's amazing. I've used it a few times. Not the desktop one yet. I only just downloaded that, but I assume it's going to work just as efficiently, minus the download portion of it from Chrome or whatever browser you're using, which is perfectly fine. But yeah, if you guys have any questions about this, definitely let me know. Real quick, I'll just kind of leave this up. I'll scroll down just so you can take a quick look on exactly what there is. Hopefully that full screen looks a little bit better for you. But yeah, I mean, there's so many options here. I don't know every option that's in here versus Adobe. So there might be one or two things that Adobe has that this doesn't have, and vice versa. There might be some extra things in here that you can't do with Adobe. I'm honestly can't vouch for that because that'd be a lot of work to sit here and just like compare each one, especially when I don't pay for the subscription for Adobe. So yeah, screw that. But yeah, down here it says, PDF 24 is free of charge even for companies. Hey, want to save your company money and look good? Talk to your boss and maybe present this to them. Say, hey, I know we got 100 users, or even if you're a small company, we got 5 people. We're paying for 5 licenses. Why not just switch to this? It's going to save us, $100 a month. It does everything Adobe does that we need. So definitely pitch this to work. You will look really good. You could save your company thousands, or if you're a large company, probably like $100,000, maybe, depending on how many people are using it. So you look really good. Make sure to hit that subscribe button if you like this. Thumbs up. I always look at the thumbs up as a way to see what you guys like. And that way I can try to bring more content that you guys are all going to enjoy. And I will see you all on the next one.